Hey, and welcome to Smart Office, weekly tips and tricks to work around Microsoft Office applications. Today, I will show you something that has to do with Microsoft Word.
How to use an existing recipient list for mail merge in Microsoft Word. With Microsoft Word, we can create group letters that contain the standard body text structure and different personal information for each recipient, a feature that is named Mail Merge. As mentioned, Mail Merge uses the following two components: the main document, which contains the text and all the other objects that we want to repeat in each letter or document; the data source, which contains the recipient information, that is, the items that change in each letter, for example, name, address, zip code, and more. All information about a specific recipient in the data source is a single data record. In each record, a single information in the data source, such as the first name or last name, is called a field. In this video, I will describe how to use an existing recipient list as a data source that has been already created. Just watch the video below. In previous videos of mine, I had described how to use the mail merge feature available in Microsoft Word. I described how to use it with the help of the ribbon. I have described how to use it with a step-by-step mail merge wizard. Now, I have already defined this document as a main document for the mail merge procedure, and I want to select a data source to connect it with the main document. From the Start Mail Merge area of the ribbon, I select the command Recipients, where we can choose the list of people we would like to send our document to. I can either type a new list, use an existing list, choose from Outlook Contacts. I'm going to use an existing list. I select the command. The Select Data Source dialog box appears, and I'm going to have to navigate and select the data source list. Address list MDB, the file name, it's an access file. I'm going to select open, and I have connected the main document with the data source list, so we can proceed in the next step of the mail merge procedure, which mentioned as before, I have described in other videos.
Thank you for watching. If you liked what you saw in this video, go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have any questions or suggestions, head down to the comment section and let me know.